hope you are all good and doing well. Welcome back to our science class, children. This is your science teacher. Children, do you watch the videos at your home? Don't forget that, children, time is very precious. So don't waste the time. Watch the videos and understood the topic. Okay? But so many times I told you that, children, after watching the video, you must need to read a textbook. So as early as possible, you take the textbooks, children. Okay? Don't forget that. Today I have come up with one more science topic, that is knowing about plants. According to our new textbook, the second lesson is knowing about plants. What is that, children? Tell with me. Yes, knowing about plants. Mokkal gurinchi telusukunta. Okay, children, in this lesson there are some topics: parts of a plant, and next one, types of roots. There are tap root system and fibrous root system. And next one, about functions of a roots. And next one, about stem and functions of stem. And next one, leaf and functions of a leaf. Okay, children. But in this video, I want to tell about just some of the topics from this lesson. Okay, children. What are the topics? First one, parts of a plant. Next one, types of roots, tap roots and fibrous root. Next one, functions of a root. And next, tuberous roots and aerial roots. Just some of the topics we will discuss in this video. Okay, children, are you ready to listen the lesson? Okay, very good. Let us enter into our topic. Children, do you see the plants in your surroundings? Yes, very good. Of course, all of us see the plants in our surroundings. If all the plants are looking like similar? No. Why? Yes, some plants are small, some plants are big, and some plants are thin, some plants are very, very large. Okay, children, there are different similarities. We see different kinds of plants around us. Yes, first of all, we learnt about parts of a plant. In our human beings, we have the parts, children: eyes, ears, nose, hands, legs. These are all the parts of human beings. Like that, plants also have some parts. We learnt about the parts of a plant. Okay, see this. This is a plant. Did you see this? Okay, this, once you see these are the roots. What are these, children? Roots. And next one, this is a stem. Stem also a part of the plant. Next one, leaves. You know very well, leaves are also parts of the plant. And what are those? Not only these, flowers, fruits, buds and branches. These are also parts of a plant. These are called branches, children. These are branches. Okay, once again I tell: roots, stem, leaves, branches. Once you see, branches means komalu. Okay, and flowers, fruits, seeds. These are all the parts of a plant. Did you get the point, children? Anybody tell what are the parts of a plant? Yes, roots, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, buds, seeds. These are all the parts of a plant. Okay, children, here once you observe the root, what is called root, children? The part of the plant that remains under the ground. The part of the plant that remains under the ground is called root. Yes or no, children? Only this part, only under the ground, like this. Okay, so this is the root. The part of the plant that remains under the ground is called root. We want to learn about something about roots in detail. Okay, children, once you observe here, types of roots: tap root and fibrous roots. Okay, there are two types of roots, children: tap roots and fibrous roots. Before going to that, you have to know about what is a root. Already I told, no, the part of the plant that remains under the ground is called root. Okay, children, here there are two types of roots. What are those? First one, tap root, and next one, fibrous root. First of all, we learned about a tap root. Okay, children, what is called tap root? In the tap root system, there is a one main root, and many small side roots are grow from the main root. Once you observe this diagram, children, this is the tap root. In the tap root system, there is only one main root. Here, this is a main root. The main root grows from the end of the stem. There is only one main root. Many small side roots are grown from the main root. These small roots are called lateral roots. Okay, children? This is the main root, and here there are small roots. The small roots are called lateral roots. The lateral roots are grown from the main root. Okay, this is the tap root system. There is simple, children. There is only one main root, and many small side roots are grown from the main root. The small side roots are called lateral roots. Okay, example for tap root system are peas, beans, mango, and tamarind and neem are the examples for the taproot system. Okay, children, peas, beans, mango, tamarind, and neem have a taproot system. Did you understand about this, children? Okay, let we go about next one. Fibrous root. What is that, children? Fibrous root. In the fibrous root system, there is no main root. Here, there is a main root. But in the fibrous root system, there is no main root. Many small side roots are grown from the end of the stem. And here you observe all roots are uniform in size and very thin. Okay? There is no main root and small. There is no main root. Many roots are grown from the end of the stem. This is a fibrous root. Okay, children? There is no main root and many roots are grown from the end of the stem, called a fibrous root. Okay, children, examples for fibrous roots are grass, rice, wheat, and onion. These are all the examples for fibrous root. Okay, children, once I will show you, observe the roots of the following. Once you observe this root, children, there is any main root? Yes, this is a main root, and many small side roots are grown from the main root. So, this is the example for tap root system. Once you see, there is a main root and many small side roots are grown from the main root. So this is the tap root. And once you observe the grass, children, there is no main root. All roots are equal in size. Okay, there is no main root. All roots are grown from the end of the stem, and all roots are thin and uniform in size. Did you clearly observe? Kanipistunda? Okay, children. These are all uniform and very thin. Example for fibrous roots. Okay, did you get the difference between these two, children? This is the tap root and this is the fibrous root. Once you observe clearly, here there is a main root. There is no main root. Many roots are grown from the end of the stem and all are thin and uniform. Here, there is a main root and small lateral roots also grown from the main root. Okay? I think, did you get the difference between fibrous roots and tap roots? Okay, children? And next one, we get functions of a root. Before going to that, we have to learn about dicot plants and monocot plants. Okay, children, in the previous class, in the 5th class, I think you learnt about the germination of a seed. Yes or no, children? Did you listen that word germination? What is called germination? Yes, a new plant grows from a seed is called germination. Or the development of a seed, into a seedling is called germination. Okay, children, in the previous class also we learnt about that. In the germination of a plant, first of all, a seed. In the structure of a seed has a seed coat. Inside the seed coat, there are small leaves are called seed leaves or cotyledons. Okay, children, have you ever listened that word? Yes, in the previous class also you have a topic about that. Those are called cotyledons. Okay, seedlings are cotyledons. Some plants have one seedling and in some other plants have two or three seedlings. Okay, children, according to the number of the cotyledons, the plants are divided into two types. Okay, what are those? Dicot plants and monocot plants. For example, if you take a bean seed, bean have two cotyledons, two seedlings. Seedlings are cotyledons, both are same. Bean seed have two cotyledons. So that is belongs to a dicot plant. Okay, children. And you take the finger millets. In the finger millets, there is only one cotyledon. So that is a monocot plant. Okay, children. Why I tell about this? Finally, all dicot plants have a taproot system and all monocot plants have a fibrous root system. Okay, children. Once you observe, dicot plants means a plant having the two cotyledons are called dicot plants, and plant having a single or one cotyledon is called a monocot plant. All dicot plants have a taproot system and all monocot plants have a fibrous root system. Children, about this you have an activity in the textbook. We will do in the next video. Okay, children. Did you understand? You remember just one thing. A plant having only one cotyledon is called a monocot plant. All monocot plants have a fibrous root. And a plant having two cotyledons, a plant belongs to a dicot plant, and all dicot plants have a taproot system. Okay? Next one, we will learn about functions of a root. What are the functions of a root? For example, you take in our body, we have hands, legs, eyes, ears. Every part in our body helps us, the entire body. Yes or no? Like that, in the plants also, every part of the plant helps the entire plant to grow. For example, you take your eyes. You have to, the eyes are used to see anything. Yes, the hands are used to do anything or writing like that. And legs are used to walking. Like that, in the plants also, stem, leaves, flowers, these are all the parts of the plant. Every part of a plant helps the entire plant to grow. Okay, first one we learned about a root. Functions of a root. What are the functions of roots? The roots fixes the plant firmly in the soil. Okay, the root fixes the plant firmly in the soil. And next one, the roots absorb water from the soil and gives to the other parts of the plant. Okay, the roots absorb water from the soil, and in some plants the roots store food also, like carrot, radish and beetroot. The roots store food also. These are the functions of the root. What are those? The root fixes the plant firmly in the soil, and next one, it absorbs water from the soil, and next one, so in some plants roots store the food in themselves. Okay, and next we will learn about tuberous roots. This is nothing but in some plants, just now I told, in some plants store food in the roots. Those are called tuberous roots. Dumpa velu. Okay, like carrot, radish and beetroot have a food in themselves, in the roots. They are called tuberous roots. Okay, children, they store food in the roots are called the tuberous roots. Examples for tuberous roots are carrot, radish and beetroot and many more. Okay, next one, children, did you see any roots above the ground? Basically, I told you that the roots remains under the ground. But did you see anywhere the roots above the ground? Once you observe a banyan tree, children, somebody starts swing on the roots of the banyan tree. Yes or no? Yes, very good. I think you are also somebody swing on the banyan tree. Okay. Here, in some plants, the roots are above the ground. In some plants, the roots are above the ground. Okay. Those are called aerial roots. Those roots are called aerial roots. Okay. Trees like banyan, sugarcane and maize have a roots you see the roots above the ground. Okay. Okay, children. This is completed with the in the lesson. Only some of the topics completed, children. Once I revise what I tell to you. Okay. First of all, we learned about a parts of a plant. The plant have a different parts like stem, leaves, roots, flowers. Next one. Yes. Birds, seeds, etc. These are all the parts of a plant, and there are two types of roots, taproot and fibrous roots. All dicot plants have a taproot and all monocot plants have a fibrous root. And difference between the taproot and fibrous root, I explained you. And next one, what are the functions of a root? What are called fibrous roots and what are aerial roots? Okay, children, this topic is completed. I will continue the lesson in the next video, children. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you would have understood the topic, children. Once again, thank you for watching.